see everyone in the house this afternoon. It gives me a great pleasure to introduce our MC for this afternoon. Everyone knows her. She is no stranger to this community. She is a native of Bear Creek, North Carolina. She is the daughter of Mr. J.C. and Willie Mae Thompson. She has one daughter, Ms. Nia Smith. But most importantly, she loves the Lord. If you know her, you would recognize her love for the Lord. Congregation, I would like to introduce you to Ms. Pamela T. Smith. Let's give her a round of applause.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Let's give Sister Tammy a hand. She always wants me to give her paper. We're classmates. Classmates are supposed to know each other, right? She knows me better than most. But all there really is to know is that I love the Lord. You love the Lord? Are you glad to be here? Let's give him some praise. How many of you come to lift up the name of Jesus? Amen. Amen. Let's stand to our feet. We're going to give God a little praise in this house tonight. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise.
God to continue to move on today. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. But in order for him to move, you got
got to be open for him to move in you. Amen. Are you open to give God praise and have an awesome time on this afternoon? We're going to move forward with our service, and we're going to have our scripture by Sister Tammy Jackson, followed by a prayer by Sister Deanne Marsh.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Coming from Psalm 150. Praise God in his temple. Praise his strength in heaven. Praise him for the mighty things he has done. Praise his supreme greatness. Praise him with trumpets. Praise him with harps and lyres. Praise him with drums and dancing. Praise him with harps and flutes. Praise him with cymbals. Praise him with loud cymbals. Praise the Lord, all living creatures.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
For that anointed prayer, and Sister Jackson, for the word is already blessed. Amen.
Yes.
She said, praise ye the Lord, all ye living creatures. Do we have any living creatures in the house? Do we have any living creatures in the house that want to give God praise? Amen. Where it says, everything that hath breath, praise ye the Lord. So we just want to start by doing a praise check. Look down your row. If you see anybody that ain't breathing, touch them, touch them. Tell them to wake up. All right, everybody breathing. Then we all got mind praise in the Lord. Somebody had to be touched over there. Amen. Amen. Give God a hand of praise. Let's stand to your feet. How many owe God a praise? If you walk here, if you walk in this building today, then you owe God a praise. Amen.
Oh God,
yes, I owe God a praise. God is good. Amen? Amen. Well, we hope you felt welcome when you came up on the grounds and walked into the church because you're standing on holy ground. Amen? And coming here is always like coming home. But we have someone who's going to welcome you in her own special way. So we're going to ask Sister Lorraine McIntosh to come at this time. My lovely God, Mama, ain't she pretty, y'all?
I just like to say, giving honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to our pastor, Reverend Cobb, other ministers that's in our building today, to our First Lady, and all of our visitors and friends, and my great church family. It is a wonderful pleasure for me to stand and welcome each of you out this afternoon. I think Sister Pam has already welcomed, but since I was on the program, I come to give you a welcome from Tucson Chapel. And we hope you feel welcome when you enter the church ground. And we just want to thank each of you for coming to help celebrate this wonderful birthday one more time. Amen. As the song said, all we owe God a praise. Amen. And here one more time. With all our Zionists healthy and in their own way. And we just want to thank God for his grace, for his mercy, for you and you and you, for our Zionists as you travel up and down the Andrews Highway. As he bless you one more time to be here to help us celebrate this wonderful occasion. Again, I want you just to get into the spirit and let God use you in your own way. Right. As we had a wonderful time last night, a wonderful time this morning, and we're looking for a glorious time again this afternoon. Just praise God in your own way. As I always say, don't worry about nobody calling the police down here. We're way down here in Eagle. So we are here to take off your shoes, because you might be tall, your feet might be cracked, because you've been in them high heels all day long. But look, we want you to get into the service, have a wonderful time. And as you come, and if you came as a stranger today, we hope that when you leave, you'll feel like a friend, because our minds is always open, our doors and our hearts. Again, I say you're welcome once, you're welcome twice, you're welcome in the name of our Jesus Christ. You are welcome. Thank you.
Amen. Is that another welcome? You feel welcome now? Amen. And I won't have any trouble with one of our guests just popping up, standing to give a response to that heartfelt welcome that was just given. And since nobody is standing, then that means I get to call on someone. And it is an awesome, awesome, awesome pleasure right now. Because this means if I can call on my mama, that means she in here. And she feeling like coming to church today. And she got that look, and she looking at me. But I got the mic today, and I'm looking back at her. My mama's been very sick and battling cancer. But she's defeated cancer in the name of Jesus. And on Tuesday, a couple more days from now, I say we because I went to almost everyone except for when I got stranded in the snow in Phoenix. But we go take our last, and I say last and declare it in the name of Jesus, chemo treatment on Tuesday. So I know she don't mind standing and giving a response on behalf of all the guests. Thank you, Mama. I'm just happy you're here. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
It is good to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
I have been down a journey.
Amen.
And I look at life now in a different perspective.
Amen.
Things that used to mean something that wasn't worth anything,
amen,
I don't think anything about it now.
Amen.
It's just good when you can wake up in the morning and put your feet on the floor.
Amen.
That's all I ask God to let me do, because I know when I put that first feet on the floor,
he's
going to let me take that other step. I'm glad to respond to Lorraine's welcome. It was beautiful.
Yes.
Amen.
But the main thing, I'm glad,
amen,
to be in the house of the Lord,
amen,
to hear and to see,
yes,
this group celebrate their anniversary.
Amen.
Because last year, I was able to sing with my group.
Yes.
I don't exactly have the energy right now, but it's just good to be, amen, in the place.
Amen.
Set
amen. 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 Thank you, Mom. Amen. Are you ready for the Zion Age?
Yes.
Let's start clapping and letting them know we're ready. Letting them know we love them. They're so excited to see each and every one of you here on today. So it is a pleasure right now to present to you. Let's put your hands together one more time for the Zionaires of Thompson Chapel, AME Zion Church, where their pastor is Reverend Jerry Cobb. They're going to come to you in their own way.
Jesus, no one name.
Dr. Kayla Jackson to come up and give us the history at this time.
The history of the Zion Airs. The Zion Airs, formerly the Thompson Chapel Mail Force, was organized in March of 1985 under the leadership of Reverend Betsy Chief. Today, the Zion Airs are celebrating their 29th singing anniversary. As one of the most celebrated joyous occasions, we tend to reflect on the joys and the sorrows of the past years. We thank God for everything He has done in our lives, even the painful experiences, because we know that He has a plan and purpose for each of us.
Amen. Amen. Give our hand. Now I present to you again the Zion Airs.
I try to treat Won't be no more work. Y'all see it's kind of hot again now.